Welcome to this quick guide on immunotherapy.
Your immune system is your body's natural defense system. It's a network of cells, tissues, and organs that protects your body by attacking cancer cells, like the blue and red cells you see here, viruses, bacteria, parasites, fungi, and other things that can make you sick.
T cells, also known as T lymphocytes, are the immune system's soldiers. They are white blood cells that can help your body fight off infection and can help fight cancer. The T cell in this video is green and is attacking the blue and red cancer cells.
Immunotherapy is a type of cancer treatment that uses the body's natural defenses to identify, attack, and kill cancer cells. Different types of immunotherapy work in different ways.
Immunotherapy treatments can help fight cancer by boosting the immune system. A revved-up immune system has more strength to fight the cancer. Marking cancer cells so that your immune system can better find and destroy them. This keeps the cancer from being able to hide from the immune system. Finding cancer cells and delivering a treatment, like chemotherapy, radiation, or even T cells, directly to those cancer cells.
There are 8 common types of immunotherapy. Checkpoint inhibitors, other monoclonal antibodies, cytokines, treatment vaccines, radioimmunotherapy, oncolytic virus therapy, BCG therapy, adoptive T-cell therapy. We'll go through each one.
Checkpoint inhibitors. Your immune system has special safeguards that keep it from attacking healthy cells. These safeguards are called checkpoints. Some cancer cells have learned how to avoid the immune system by turning on these checkpoints. Checkpoint inhibitors turn checkpoints off so that your immune system can fight your cancer. Some of the cancers that checkpoint inhibitors are being used to treat are melanoma, lung cancer, blood cancers, head and neck cancer, kidney and bladder cancer, and cancers that test positive for biomarkers including MSI-high and DMMR.
Other monoclonal antibodies. Checkpoint inhibitors are one kind of monoclonal antibody. There are other kinds of monoclonal antibodies, some of which are immunotherapies. In addition to blocking checkpoints, monoclonal antibodies can help the immune system find and destroy tumors by attaching to specific proteins on cancer cells to mark them, bring treatment to them, or kill them. Right now, monoclonal antibody immunotherapies are most commonly used to treat blood cancers. You can learn more about immunotherapy treatments for blood cancers on the Immunotherapy and Blood Cancers page on the Cancer Support Community website, www.cancersupportcommunity.org/IOblood.
Cytokines. These drugs make the immune system's T cells grow faster. They also work with other immune cells to fight the cancer. Two types of cytokines used to treat cancer are interleukins and interferon. High-dose interleukin-2, or IL-2, can be used to treat advanced melanoma and kidney cancer.
Treatment vaccines. Treatment vaccines teach the immune system's T cells to recognize and attack cancer cells. They can be used to treat people with cancer and those trying to prevent certain types of cancer from occurring. Other types of vaccines are being studied to prevent cancer from returning. A treatment vaccine like Prevenge or Sipuleucel-T is an option for some patients with advanced prostate cancer. This vaccine is made out of a patient's own white blood cells. Not all treatment vaccines are made from your own cells.
Radioimmunotherapy. Radioimmunotherapy sends high doses of radiation directly to individual cancer cells. It does this by attaching radioactive atoms to monoclonal antibodies. This brings the radiation directly to the cancer cells, making it less harmful to normal cells. Radioimmunotherapy is used to treat certain types of lymphoma. Clinical trials are studying its effectiveness in other types of cancers.
Oncolytic virus therapy. Oncolytic virus therapy is a type of targeted therapy that is able to kill cancer cells. This therapy uses altered viruses that only multiply inside of cancer cells, causing them to die. But these altered viruses can't make you sick. Several different oncolytic viruses are being tested in clinical trials. One oncolytic virus therapy that is injected directly into the tumor is used to treat some patients with melanoma.
BCG therapy. BCG therapy is used in early-stage bladder cancer. It is put directly into the bladder with a catheter, where it creates an anti-cancer immune response. BCG therapy helps prevent a recurrence in about 70% of patients with early-stage bladder cancer.
Adoptive T-cell therapy. For this treatment, T-cells are removed from a patient and modified in a lab. The modified cells are then put back into the patient's blood to fight the cancer. CAR T-cell therapy is one type of adoptive T-cell therapy. It's used to treat certain types of leukemia and lymphoma. To learn more about CAR T-cell therapy, go to www.cancersupportcommunity.org/CART.
Most immunotherapy treatments are given using an IV through a vein. Treatments can be given in a doctor's office or a cancer clinic. Immunotherapy may be given with chemotherapy or targeted therapy.
Right now, immunotherapies are only approved to treat certain types of cancers, but many clinical trials are underway. You can learn more about how to find an immunotherapy clinical trial on our website at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/clinical-trials.
You may be asking, is immunotherapy right for me? If you have an autoimmune disorder or have received an organ transplant, your doctor may not be able to give you immunotherapy. Or they may want to watch you much closer if you are on immunotherapy. Immunotherapy can be very expensive, but is usually covered by insurance. Before you begin treatment, make sure you know how much the treatment costs, what your insurance will cover, and what you will be responsible for paying. Be sure to ask about options to talk with financial navigators or financial counselors. To learn more, visit our Frankly Speaking About Cancer Cost and Care webpage at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/cost.
Immunotherapy has helped many patients, but it doesn't work for everyone. Researchers are trying to learn more about when it works, when it doesn't work, and why. Some immunotherapy treatments can cause severe side effects. Patients who develop side effects should tell their healthcare team right away. To learn more about side effects, see our eLearning guide, Immunotherapy Side Effects. You can learn more about immunotherapy treatments on our website at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/immunotherapy.